On New Year's Day, California joined the growing list of states and the District of Columbia where it is now legal to sell marijuana. While state and local leaders may see marijuana as a taxable cash crop, the Trump administration has a different point of view. On Thursday, Attorney General Jeff Sessions rescinded an Obama administration policy that discouraged federal prosecutors, in most instances, from bringing charges in places where marijuana is legal under state law. Joining me now from Washington, D.C. is John Hudak, the Deputy Director of the Center for Effective Public Management at the Brookings Institution, to help assess the impact of this move. So let's just, in plain English, what is the Attorney General calling for?
What the Attorney General is calling for is the freeing up for U.S. attorneys, for federal prosecutors, to start to go after state legal marijuana businesses who are complying with state law and are serving customers in states that have chosen to reform their marijuana laws, something that the Obama administration put protections in against. The Trump administration is repealing that.
And this was something that Attorney General Sessions said that he wasn't really going to take action on during his confirmation hearing, right?
The Attorney General has had a lot of mixed language when it comes to this issue. He's been cagey. There have been moments where he has suggested that he saw the standing policy as a good one or one to keep in place. And there are other moments where you hear the Attorney General using the type of war on drugs language about marijuana that we really haven't heard from the top tiers of administrations for 15 or 20 years.
But what happens? There are small businesses that are taking steps already in states where it is legal, and there are investors, there's possible bank loans, all sorts of institutions that are involved in this economy. What happens when this statement from on high comes in? Does it add some uncertainty into how these businesses fare?
Well, certainly the statement itself, the policy change itself, adds uncertainty to this industry. And of course, uncertainty is bad for any business. But the statement itself won't necessarily enact change. Change will happen when U.S. attorneys, working closely with DEA and other law enforcement entities, begin enforcing against these businesses. That day may never come, but if it does, that will be the moment where the industry feels the real effects of this policy. And you'll start to see ripple effects spreading out from there.
There's already been pushback from Senator Gardner in Colorado. And how do states respond to this? What can they do to encourage what they might see as an important part of their economy?
Well, you're right about Senator Gardner. In fact, dozens and dozens of House members and senators have come out and slammed the Attorney General for this policy, in part because it actually goes back on what were statements by the president when he was running for office about his view on this issue. He said that it should be a state's rights issue. So what do states have to do? What can they do? First off, they don't have to help the federal government enforce federal law. There is a protection against that under the 10th Amendment to the Constitution. And so you will see a lot of states, most states probably, just say to the federal government, if you want to enforce your laws, go ahead and do it on your own. You're not getting a dime of state revenue to help do this. And that really is the first line of protection that states have.
But what about if the DEA wants to come in to a growing operation in California or Colorado and carry out what they say is, this is my job, I'm doing it, this is what the federal law says, right?
There's really nothing states can do. If DEA goes into a state with recreational marijuana and begins to arrest people, shut down businesses, seize assets, seize plants, there's not much the state can do to combat that. It is illegal under federal law. DEA and U.S. attorneys have the authority to investigate and bring charges against these entities. And it would be a difficult day for the marijuana industry. It would be a day that may frustrate governors across the country. But it's a day that would be completely in compliance with federal law.
All right, John Hudak of the Brookings Institution, thanks so much.
Thank you.